Hi, it's Dr. Nick with the ECG Academy, and this is a wicked crazy chalk talk that I'm going to present to you. This is for advanced users, but I think everybody can get something out of this. So look at this rhythm strip. Just imagine that the patient is up on the medical floor and starts to complain of palpitations, and you notice that the heart rate is really quite fast. Look at that. It's close to 160 beats per minute, I would say. And you look, and the QRS appears to be really very narrow, very sharp and spiky, and it looks like there might be a P wave in front of each beat, but the PR interval just really kind of looks very short, doesn't it? It's only maybe 100 milliseconds or so. A lot of people would look at this and say, oh, could this be WPW? Could this be some sort of SVT? So what should you do first? Well, the answer is to get a 12 lead. And here is the 12 lead with that AVL right up here. You see how narrow that is? But the rest of the cardiogram looks very bizarre, wide and crazy looking, a rate of about 160 beats per minute, but very regular. I mean, it's not like the last chalk talk where you had atrial fibrillation in the left bundle. Now, didn't it look like there was a P wave in front of the QRS and a short PR? Well, it turns out that wasn't a P wave. It was part of the QRS complex. So let me show you an enlarged view of this. Okay, so here's that AVL with the funny bump in front of the QRS complex, but if you look at AVF, you'll see that the onset of the QRS complex, which is just in front of this heavy line, corresponds with that bump. That's crazy. That bump there is part of the QRS complex. You see how it starts at the same point as this QRS? So the QRS goes from here to here. That's all QRS. There's no P wave that you can see. And the QRS duration is about 110 on this side, about 30 on this side. So it's about 140 milliseconds, certainly wider than three small boxes. So that's why that's not a P wave. It's part of the QRS. And don't get fooled about that. You have to look at multiple leads. So what's the axis here? The axis, yeah, it's halfway between 1 and AVL. There's no true isoelectric. So if it was isoelectric to lead 1 and it's positive in 2, 3, and F, that would give you an axis of plus 90. If it was isoelectric to AVL, that would give you plus 60. So the answer is in between. It's plus 75, which is normal, right? But it's wide. And it kind of looks a little bit like a left bundle branch block in lead 1, but in lead AVL, it doesn't look anything like a left bundle branch block. So now let's look at the precordial leads and try to get a sense of if it follows any particular bundle branch pattern. In V1, it looks like it's up, so could this be a right bundle type of thing? But that's really sharp, and then it's got an S wave. It doesn't have an RSR prime. So usually you'll see something like that if it's a right bundle. And then the rest of it is all positive, which is really crazy. Look at that. Here, I want you to notice something. V1 is positive. All the way out to V6, it's all positive. They're all upgoing. What do we call that? It's got a special name. It's called precordial concordance. All the beats are concordant with each other. They all go in the same direction. That means they all go up or they all go down. And what is that strongly suggestive of? It's suggestive of ventricular tachycardia. This is arising from the ventricle somewhere. It's not following the normal conduction system, and it doesn't follow any particular bundle branch block pattern. So now the question is, if you think it's VTAC, what should you be looking for? What do you need to find to nail down the diagnosis? And I actually showed this tracing to three cardiologists, and they all kind of looked at it and said, I don't know, I'm not really sure. Let's zoom in again, but this time we'll look at V1. And I like V1 because you can see P waves really easily there. If you look at any particular QRS complex, it looks like there's a little Q wave to start, and then there's an R, and then there's an S wave, and then there's a nice smooth ST segment and a T wave. And then again, you have a little Q and a tall R and an S and a T wave, okay? So all these beats look alike, don't they? Except for this one. What's different? And that's because of this right there. You see that on the ST segment? And you can see it in this lead too? It's a P wave. That's right. It's a dissociated P wave. It's not a P wave that occurs in the same relationship with every QRS. It's just there. It's sticking out there. And so that right there is evidence of AV dissociation. And that pretty much proves that this is sustained monomorphic ventricular tachycardia. They gave the guy amiodarone, and eventually the tachycardia broke. And so after the tachycardia breaks, now what you see, a normal sinus rhythm with a first degree AV block. You see the PR is a little bit long, about 260 or so. Narrow, normal looking QRS complexes without any pathological Q waves, so no evidence of an old MI. And look, there's a PVC, but that morphology, positive in 2 in AVF, and you got that little bump and a very sharp negative deflection in AVL, and then it's positive in V4, V5, V6. That is an ectopic beat arising from the same spot. In this case, you actually have a retrograde P wave that you can see on the ST segment. So these are ventricular ectopic beats coming from the same area as the VTAC did. Now, what does that make you think of? Well, the crazy thing is that the patient has normal left ventricular function. His ejection fraction is like 70%. So this could be a focal ventricular tachycardia due to an automatic focus. And you have a lot of ectopic beats here coming from that same focus. So you might be able to suppress this with medical therapy, or you could potentially do an ablation. But you need to be able to look at a tracing like this. Don't look at it and call it a wide complex tachycardia. That's just hedging your bet, and it doesn't help you treat the patient. Go back to ECG Academy and study the notion of AV dissociation and watch a whole bunch more chalk talks with VTAC on it so that you can focus your eyes and see this one little spot where you have one little tiny P wave is what gives you that answer 100% of the time. Okay, until next time, this is Dr. Nick with the ECG Academy. Thanks for watching.